Finally tonight, shedding new light on WikiLeaks. This evening on Frontline, correspondent Martin Smith unravels the mystery of Bradley Manning, the Army private who allegedly stole thousands of classified government documents. One part of the tale has been largely unknown, the story of the hacker who blew the whistle on Manning. Here's how it unfolds from tonight's program titled WikiSecrets.
In late May, a hacker in California was contacted and began a chat with someone using the screen name Bradass87. If you had free rein over classified networks and you saw incredible things, awful things, what would you do?
He spoke in hypotheticals at first. Even then, I largely blew it off. There just aren't enough hours in the day to correspond with everybody that wants to correspond with me.
The hacker, Adrian Lamo, was well known in the cyber underground. In 2003, he'd been arrested for hacking the New York Times. And the day before the chat, Lamo was featured in an article on Wired.com that discussed his psychiatric problems. Bradass87 would keep up his chat with Lamo for the next 4 days.
He talked a lot about his personal life, about his relationships, about his experiences in the military, about experiences back home.
Lamo says the person also contacted him via email, and they became friends on Facebook. It was Bradley Manning, intelligence analyst in Iraq. And in his profile, there was the chat name, Bradass87. He read more.
Looking at his Facebook page, I got the sense that Bradley was very depressed.
Then, during one of their chats, Bradass87 started dropping hints about a crazy white-haired Aussie.
He mentioned Julian Assange in the context. Julian was the individual at WikiLeaks who he had initially established contact with.
He also mentioned that he had leaked thousands of classified documents, including a huge tranche of diplomatic cables.
I asked him if there was any way to recover the documents. He indicated that they had already been uploaded to WikiLeaks' server. It was a fairly unambiguous statement.
Lamo says he believed Manning was a security risk and worried that if he didn't say something, he could be party to a crime. He called an old friend, Tim Webster.
Adrian was quite conflicted. We had a back and forth where he was concerned about whether or not this was the right thing to do, whether to betray this person's trust was appropriate given his actions. Adrian recognized that we can't have somebody out there leaking classified information like this. It's not something he could allow to continue.
Webster coached Lamo to keep up the chat as long as possible to find out more details. He also alerted the Pentagon that they may have a security breach. Lamo was nervous and felt trapped.
There was no correct option. There was only the least incorrect one. Either way, I would have been screwing somebody over. I had to pick who. There was no option to just sit back and wash my hands of the responsibility, because that in and of itself would have been making a choice.
Lamo then called a reporter he knew at Wired.com.
He called me to tell me that he had a meeting set up the next day with the FBI and the Army because he was turning in somebody who'd contacted him online and confessed to passing classified information to someone he described as a foreign national.
Polson convinced Lamo to hand him a copy of the chat and then asked a colleague to follow up on any leads.
We went through the chat logs and we looked at what else he mentioned. Tyler Watkins was named in the chat logs.
Zetter called Watkins. He told her about a conversation he'd had with Manning during Manning's January visit to Boston.
Brad had told him that he had uncovered information that concerned him and he was considering leaking it. And so he was weighing that, whether or not the good that he felt he would be doing in leaking the information outweighed any kind of, you know, personal suffering that he might undergo for leaking it.
On May 26th, 2010, Bradley Manning was arrested. It was posted on Facebook.
We got confirmation that Manning had been arrested when Manning called his aunt from jail.
And asked her to update his Facebook page with a message.
It would be his final Facebook entry.
Frontline airs on most PBS stations tonight, and you can find a conversation with Martin Smith on the Rundown blog on our website.